this is a very important issue in public health and in pediatrics and in child psychiatry. So an overweight person is defined by the CDC, Center of Disease Control and Prevention, as being at a BMI, body mass index, at 85 or more. That has to be specific for age and for gender. Now, the obesity definition is also by the CDC and indicates that a person is obese if it is at a BMI of 95th or over percentile, specific for age and gender. The pediatric obesity is a very, very large problem. It has increased tremendously in the last 30 years, even though there have been initiatives to decrease the obesity and the overweight in children and adolescents, we are not seeing that decrease. We are seeing a tremendous increase in this population, to the point that right now, the latest research shows that it's considered a pandemic, even though it was considered an epidemic until a few years ago. It's a very serious problem. According to the research, the children who are white or Asian American have less rate of obesity than African American and Hispanic children and children of other races. The children who are obese or overweight, they are subjective to a lot of teasing, stigmatization, bullying, cyberbullying, which of course has tremendous consequences in mental health and also in physical health. And the outcomes in mental health are very serious, you know. Depression. We see depression with the risk for suicide. We see anxiety. We also see increase in mood disorders, especially the bipolar disorder, with also risk for suicide. Eating disorders are also a consequence of this problem. And then we have the low self-image, low self-esteem, low self-worth, and in general, very low quality of life compared to the children of the general population. The main factors that need to be considered that contribute to the obesity and the overweight and therefore to mental health is multifactorial. So we have genetic factors, which means the genes are going to predispose the kids to be obese. Epigenetic factors that are super important, especially with mother's health during pregnancy. If the mother has used alcohol or nicotine or other drugs, or has been subjected to violence, domestic violence. So these are very important factors, or the diet also of the mother, that are going to modify the expression of the genes. Therefore, the kids could become obese later on in life. Besides the epigenetic, we have psychological factors. As I mentioned before, these children have low self-image, low self-esteem. They could have depression, anxiety, and other problems, even suicide. So those are psychological factors. And then we have the environmental factors, which are also very, very important, because if the child has been abused or neglected, or if they are subjected to toxic stress or adverse circumstances in life or domestic violence, all those environmental factors are going to make the problem worse in terms of obesity and in terms of mental health. Of course, that's important after we see how complex, how important, and how serious the problem is. We need to think about what can be done. So I believe that has to be a team approach. The team approach indicates that all of us need to be together in this mission. We have to include the pediatricians, psychiatrists, psychologists, counselors, nutritionists, nurses, schools, the daycare people, and in general the community to work together so we can promote a healthier lifestyle. We need to, and the families, I forgot to mention the families, which is the most important element in the team. So we need to promote healthier lifestyles, including diet that has less saturated fats, less carbohydrates, physical activity. Physical activity is very important, and we need to believe that the recent problems with increasing screen time for the kids is probably decreasing the physical activity for the kids, and it's interrupting the sleep hours, which is also very, very important in a healthy lifestyle. We also need to make sure that the parents get educated, so the parents are able to recognize the mental health issues in the children who are obese and overweight. And so all these doctors and all these professionals in the team need to work together to address this, not just the treatment, but also prevention.